sa kamay ng isang magaling na pastel artist, from a distance, you could hardly differentiate, no? The effect of an oil painting to a pastel, no? Soft pastel. Ako si Phil de la Cruz, isang painter and printmaker. Start ako professionally 1980s up to now. So, matagal-tagal na rin sa art scene. So, pastel is always one of the favorites for the young artists. One is because it's easier to transport. Hindi ka mukha ng mga ibang medium na you need brass, you need oil medium, you need turpentine, you need a heavier canvas. So yung pastel and watercolor also, sila yung mga very comfortable medium to bring along. Especially kung gusto mo ng mga on the spot, yung plein air, ang pastel ay isa sa mga very versatile medium to use in outdoor. So, ang pastel ay very soft in terms of effect, no, na kaya niyang i-approximate yung oil medium, parang kung sa kamay ng isang magaling na pastel artist, from a distance you could hardly differentiate, no, the effect of an oil painting to a pastel, no, soft pastel. So yung pastel naman ay marami naman siyang mga variations, mga ano na paggagamit mo. Meron diyang oil pastel, may soft pastel or chalk pastel. Meron namang it comes in powdered form. Lately, meron mga lumalabas na iridescent. No, so yung artist ngayon ay very I would say spoiled, no? Spoiled tayo ngayon, ano? Yung any color that you can imagine in your palette, it's available in the market, no? Unlike nung mga early days na ang mga kulay ay limited, ang sticks ay very limited, and some of them are not consistent in terms of softness, in terms of coarseness. Ngayon, ang mga pastel ay very fine. Very soft, so you can use the same technique like in oil. In oil, there is such thing as fat over lean, no? Now, wherein you use like a surface that are a little bit hard, you put along, you put over it. A more liquid consistency in oil, we call it fat over lean, na nagkakaroon ng glazing. Now in pastel, you can almost practically do the same, no? Kasi merong hard pastel that you can start working on it, and then layered it with a powdery and softer pastel that comes in the same as doing the same effect in oil. So yung magagaling talagang magpastel, I've seen some good pastelists in classic style, na talagang pag malayo, oil na oil siya, di ba? Oil na oil ang dating, no? I hope in the future more artists will use it not just for their comprehensive study for final paintings or study for major work, but use pastel as the medium itself, no, as a serious medium, no? Because the only the only restriction here is when it comes to size, no? When it comes to size, but artists are so creative that they can get away with the size or with the because now we welcome some new ideas like incorporating pastel to another medium, crossing over with soft pastel to acrylic, probably use not just paper but use also linen or canvas. So artists now are not just concentrating on the traditional way of executing the medium, but using the medium in other different ways possible. So crossover na. Advocacy namin is to popularize and make pastel medium as an important medium that artists can use in expressing their art in art making. No, they can use a very versatile medium like oil pastel, soft pastel. It comes in stick. It comes in powder. You can even brush it. And it comes in pencil, right? Wala na limit, no? The art, the limit is the creativity of the artist. Yes. Hindi na pure na pastel, hindi na pure na acrylic, hindi na pure na oil, pinagko-crossover. So, interesting na yung at this point in time yung manufacturers are also kumbaga sumasabay dun sa mga what I could say need, no, requirements ng artist, no, like the early masters. Sila yung gumagawa ng kanilang medium, no? Sila yung nag-grind ng kanilang pigments, sila yung naghahalo ng kanilang medium, yung oil, to come up with their desired effect, no? Eh ngayon naman, yung mga manufacturers, nakikita nila, kailangan pala merong mas malambot na pastel kasi parang nag-aano sila yung patong-patong layering, which is very difficult in pastel, no? If all the sticks are in equal coarseness or parehong matigas, hindi mo may patong yung ano. So pag yung malambot na ipupunta mo sa matigas na area na hindi nagagalaw, no? So they can produce a very subtle, and the tonal values are longer and more effective, especially when you are working on chiaroscuro, on light and shadow. It's very effective yung palambot yung ano, yung pastel. Yun yung nakita ng mga ng mga manufacturers, no, na kailangan ng mga artists ng mas malambot din. So artists are now using different kinds of different brands, no? May ibang brand na medyo matigas, merong ibang brand na malambot, merong brand na iridescent, merong brand na mas powdery na kailangan doon sa kanilang need. So ang artist ngayon, mga young artist especially, na mag-uumpisa ng pastel, mas spoiled, no? Nandiyan na lahat, no? Ang possibilities are all here. It's only the artist who have this, kumbaga, ang limit mo, yung creativity mo. I can see in the future na itong pastel will be one of the major art form in the Philippines. Sa ibang bansa, siyempre, well accepted. Dito sa atin kasi, locally, ang mga enthusiast, art enthusiast, mga collectors, they tend to look at the, not just the pastel, but any artwork on paper, as lesser in terms of artistic value, probably. Not because hindi siya at par with the other medium, but because maybe one factor is the weather, no?
Yeah.
So since the paper is the support of pastel or watercolor, the collectors give more, interest in medium that is the surface is canvas or sturdier and more durable than artwork on paper. But nonetheless, it does not mean it is lower or lesser in terms of hierarchy in art, no? If you talk of the integrity of the work, the versatility of the artist who handles the medium, may kukumpara mo siya sa maski anong medium, whether in oil or in acrylic or in watercolor. So, depende yan sa artist na nag-handle ng material, nag-handle ng medium. So, I am very positive that in the future, ang pastel will be one of the major art form here in the Philippines.